Fitness News.
There aren't many people who like receiving telemarketing calls, especially when phone calls from IRS scam artists are on the rise. One tech company says consumers received 18 billion robocalls last year. Danielle Nottingham reports on how apps can cut down the annoying calls.
Robocalls have become a way of life for most Americans. Friends Lori Meissenheimer and Dana Cipolla have both received threatening calls from scam artists posing as the IRS.
You would be taken under custody by the local cops as there is more serious.
The local cops. Local cops.
Hello?
Christy Compacharo and her kids get robocalls daily.
I feel like I have to say, you know, gotta go, and I hang up.
Christy often receives calls with her 818 Los Angeles area code, even though the call could be from out of state or overseas. It's known as neighbor spoofing. Computer software mimics the first six digits of your phone number. Authorities say this man, Adrian Abramovich, is a robocall kingpin behind millions of spoofed calls that pitched timeshares.
I'm not the kingpin of robocalling that is alleged.
He's facing a $120 million fine from the FCC and on Wednesday testified before a Senate committee under subpoena.
I'm not going to answer that question.
You're invoking the Fifth Amendment.
I'm invoking the Fifth Amendment, yes.
He didn't give many direct answers, but did say it's simple to buy the software for a robocall operation.
The technology is easy to obtain and can be used by anyone.
Phone providers have recently taken steps to try and intercept unwanted robocalls. There are also several smartphone apps available to block them, including Truecaller, HIYA, and Nomo Robo. Another called Umail is a free service that tricks robocallers into thinking you don't exist.
We play an out-of-service message. Doo-doo-doo. This number's out of service. To any number that we recognize as a bad number.
But it can be difficult for the apps to spot and block all the numbers because robocallers are constantly changing tactics to get you to answer. Danielle Nottingham, CBS News,